The dollar is dead as a public, private, and personal problem-solving tool. Is the dollar dying as a problem-solving tool for you? Did you lose a lot of dollars in the stock market bubble, where corporate executives issued themselves bastard stock options, which they sold to you, pocketing the money in mansions and mistresses rather than in jobs? For you, the dollar died as a private problem-solving tool. Do you worry that Social Security will not be there to provide you with the dollars you need for basic needs when you retire? For you, the dollar is not a retirement tool. Do you find that you don't have enough dollars for basic health care? For you, the dollar has died as a personal problem-solving tool. Do you recognize that public education is declining and that you don't have dollars for private education? The dollar is dying as a tool of education. Do you feel less safe on the streets and in your home because dollars are no longer available for police and fire budgets? Yet, the rich who get unearned tax gains live in gated communities protected by private police force. For you, the dollar is dead as a problem-solving paper for safety. Are you worried about your future falling below your previous standard of living? For you, the dollar is dying as your problem-solving tool. Are you willing to work but cannot find a job? For you, your current time is worth nothing in dollars. Currencies came into existence to help people to solve problems in different places and different times. Currencies are symbols of people's time at work. Instead of taking a part of the daily production in goods or services, you take a symbol of your time and partial ownership of the daily production. Currencies are the symbols of your life substance. Most people don't realize that the word currency comes from the expression, "What is your time currently worth?" or "What are you currently worth?" These are variations of the expression, "Time is money and money is time." By having a widely accepted currency, people can accept the current symbol of time for their work time or problem-solving time. A more primitive form of people exchanging their work time is bartering. Bartering is very inefficient. Would you rather have a good currency requiring no bartering or a bad currency that requires bartering all the time? As with the origin and meaning of currency, another simple facet of currency is not appreciated. All currencies have been products of human time. Currencies are the common, intermediate product by which producers exchange their work time over distances in space and time. Currencies vary in the human time cost and in the human time worth, substance versus symbol. The cheaper the cost of a currency, the easier it is to steal the symbols of time to own the substance of time. Consider the difference in cost and thievability of gold and paper. If a currency is a cow with unique spotty features, it is a lot harder to steal a cow than if currency is magnetic spots in a computer. Why is the dollar dying as a problem-solving tool? More importantly than the dying dollar is the substance of your time symbols. Why is your time dying, becoming worth less and less? Fewer and fewer people and almost no economists recognize and enshrine the generic name of dollars, currency, from current time. An honest currency is one which rewards honest problem solvers with the time that they currently create or save when they solve a time-wasting problem. When business privileges and tax benefits give someone something for nothing, then other people have had their time cheapened and stolen. The victims of dying currencies suffer from fewer dollars that are worth less and less in an inflationary world. Why is it illegal for a bank robber to steal hundreds, while it is legal for a CEO to steal millions? Why? Habitual politicians and tenured economist. Curse the habitual politicians and tenured economists, for they are holding the bloody knives and smoking guns as they stand over the dying dollar. The aggregation of wealth transfer by the habitual politicians constitutes giving the symbols of problem solving to a few or few. The symbols are taken from the many who are the problem solvers of substance. This is welfare. One example of welfare is the 401ks, which transferred money from retirement funds into the fat pockets of executives, directors, and politicians. Your dollars are dying as problem-solving tools because America is owned by fewer and fewer people. How many dollars can you have, and what can they be worth if the politicians and economists have orchestrated a massive symphony of welfare? How healthy are your dollars if you are chasing dollars that are dying? The key to a good living currency is to keep it current in its problem-solving time. The most honest currency would be one that keeps the value of human time constant and current. The best way to keep a currency honest is to have honest democracy that stops the private theft by dishonest politicians through public lawmaking. Essential to timeism and its application is the creation of time, that is, human productivity per clock hour. The ultimate human productivity per capita is good, honest democracy, which organizes people to solve the biggest problems first with the best, efficient, and inexpensive solution. Right after the ultimate productivity is the penultimate productivity, a good, honest currency. Why are both forms of productivity declining? The U.S. Congress. Anyone who thinks our national problem-solving process is getting better does not understand the constipation of Congress from campaign kaopectate. The blood of our American economic body is dying as it bleeds away for an oil war. The one-time costs of 9/11 are being dwarfed by the exitless exodus of dollars into the sands of Iraq. From an honest $250 billion national surplus when he took office, Junior Bush in 2003 has a lying $500 billion deficit. A loss of $750 billion is a lot of dead presidents. There are many reasons why major economic forces do not want to help the U.S. in Iraq. The European community wants to end America's dollar monopoly as the world's currency, which is a major reason for creating the euro. The days of American monetary colonialism are numbered, for the world no longer wants to underwrite the American way of life based on our exporting domestic unemployment and inflation. The quagmire of Iraq bleeds American military and financial might. For Europe, financial parity is achieved without financial sacrifice. For China, military parity is achieved without military spending. Why fight your foes if they are willing to commit suicide? Not only are American soldiers sadly slogging in the blood of fallen comrades, but they are part of a multi-billion-dollar bloodbath of America's economic blood, the dying dollar. Unlike veterans of World War I, World War II, Korean War, and Vietnam, Operation Enduring Freedom soldiers will come home to an economy that is more like the dying South after the Civil War. Jobless veterans of Iraq will find higher taxes due to Iraqi grants instead of loans. Jobless veterans of Iraq will find jobs shipped to Iraq to help its economy. Sweating in the hot cauldron of Iraq, American soldiers are like Jews building gas ovens for Nazis. The house of humanity is on fire, and the arsonists are in charge of putting out the fire. The dying, bleeding dollar has an operating room full of phlebotomists, vampires, and other bloodsuckers. We are suffering an existential meltdown of our problem-solving tools because of habitual politicians. Your dollars are dying from legalized thievery, of the life-supporting value. Your dollars are dying because greedy politicians waste your tax dollars and future tax dollars to fund oil wars. Every wasted dollar cheapens and kills all dollars, like a wasted moment lessens your life. In troubled times of habitual problems, the only thing worse than not voting is voting for a habitual politician or a son of a habitual politician. The tenured economists have increasingly legitimized the habitual politicians, legalizing unearned wealth. As noted in the segments on the Lifehour, the key to a living currency is a universal time clock and payroll system which quantifies and qualifies the value of your time. What does one have when a currency is kept current in the value of people using their heads, capita, to solve problems? Capitalism per capita. That is, the symbols of one's time matches the substance of one's time-saving problem-solving. Touchtone Manager is such a system that was created a few years ago for this purpose. You can help bring about an honest currency by investing time into building better democracy and capitalism through timeism, which will reward you in life hours, the currency that transcends the boundaries of nations and centuries. If you want the time of your life and the hours of your life to be worth more, be optimistic, opt for timeism and life hours. Otherwise, your dollars will die in both symbols and substance.
Some people say a man is made out of mud. A poor man's made out of muscle and blood. Muscle and blood and skin and bones. A mind that's weak and a back that's strong. You load 16 tons, what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, 'cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. I was born one morning when the sun didn't shine. I picked up my shovel and I walked to the mine. I loaded 16 tons of number 9 coal, and the straw boss said, well, bless my soul, you load 16 tons, what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, 'cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. I was born one morning, it was drizzling rain. Fighting and trouble are my middle name. I was raised in the canebrake by an old mama lion. Can't know a high-toned woman make me walk the line. You load 16 tons, what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, 'cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store. If you see me coming, better step aside. A lot of men didn't, a lot of men died. One fist of iron, the other of steel. If the right one don't get you, then the left one will. You load 16 tons, what do you get? Another day older and deeper in debt. St. Peter, don't you call me, 'cause I can't go. I owe my soul to the company store.